हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी चैप्टर फेडरलिज्म पार्ट टू। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी What makes India a federal country? We know that India became independent after a painful and bloody partition. Soon after independence, several princely states became a part of India. The constitution declared India as a union of states. Although it didn't use the word federation, the Indian Union is based on the principles of federation. The Constitution originally provided for a two-tiered system of government. The Union government, what we call central government, representing the Union of India, and the state government. Later on, a third tier of federalism was added in the form of panchayats and municipalities. As in any federation, these different tiers enjoy separate jurisdiction. The constitution clearly provided a threefold distribution of legislative powers between the union government and the state government. Thus, it contains three leaves: the union lease, state lease, concurrent lease, and residuary powers. Union lease. It includes a subject of national importance such as defense of a country, foreign affairs, banking, communication and currency. They are included in this list because we need a uniform policy on these matters throughout the country. The union government alone can make laws relating to subjects mentioned in the union list. State list. It contains subjects of state and local importance such as police, trade, commerce, agriculture, and irrigation. The state government alone can make laws relating to the subject mentioned in the state list. Concurrent list. It includes subjects of common interest to both the union government as well as state governments, such as education, forest, trade unions, marriage, adoption, and succession. Both the union as well as state governments can make laws on the subject mentioned in this list. If any conflicts arise, then the law made by union government will prevail in the country. Residuary power. Now the question arises, what about subjects that do not fall in any of these three lists, or subjects like computer software that came up after the constitution was made? So according to the constitution, the union government has the powers to legislate on these residuary subjects. Some special features of Indian constitutions. As I told you earlier, in federation, both levels of government are not given equal powers. Thus, all states in Indian Union do not have identical powers. Some states enjoy a special status. For example, Jammu and Kashmir. It has its own constitution. Many provisions of the Indian constitution are not applicable to this state without the approval of state assembly. Indians who are not permanent resident of this state cannot buy land or house here. Similar special provision exists for some other states of India as well. Second one, special powers to central government. There are some units of the Indian Union which enjoy very little power. These are areas which are either too small to become an independent state, but which could not be merged with any of the existing states. These areas like Chandigarh or Lakshadweep or capital city of Delhi are called union territories. These territories do not have the powers of state. Central government has special powers in running these areas. Third one, there is need of consent of both houses of parliament to make changes in the basic structure of constitution. So it is not easy to make changes to the provisions given in the constitution. For this, a special provision is there in the constitution because parliament cannot on its own change this arrangement. Any change to it has to be first passed by both the houses of parliament with at least 2/3 majority. Then it has to be ratified by the legislature of at least half of the total states in India. Fourth one, the role of judiciary. Judiciary plays an important role in implementation of constitutional provisions and procedure. If any disputes arise about the division of powers, the High Court and the Supreme Court make a decision. The union and the state government also has the power to raise resources by levying taxes in order to carry on government and the responsibilities assigned to each of them. Thanks.